All right, I think we're live now. We'll make sure the sound is working and everything. Here's Sam Healey.
Hello, sirs.
He's the French today.
And madams. Vive la France!
What we're doing here is we're playing a special version of Memoir 44. Memoir 44, one of the expansions, was called Breakthrough, where it's basically a double map. Actually, I think it's more than a double map. It's more than a double map.
It's going to be our background music for tonight.
And, yeah, we can't ever play music in these because of the copyrights. But it's more than a double map, I think. I don't know. But anyway, yeah. It's a much deeper map. So it's going to be a slightly longer game, although we'll try to play through quickly. In this game, my goal is to get 12 medals. I'll get medals by killing his stuff. And since he doesn't have that many more than 12 units. And one of those medals, I must get one of my units out over here on the exit over there. So I have to get through there. And there is a whole pile of French units in my way. This is the dial plan. So I'm not sure what the name is. Oh, this is Breakthrough to Gembleau. If I get through this, I get to play
Gembleau.
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 So we'll need to shuffle the cards.
Shuffling.
And
you silly
I get to go
Kenigget.
First.
That wasn't me.
That was definitely you.
That was definitely me.
All right, so we're going to start in a second as soon as Sam shuts the thing. Oh, by the way, this board is a pre-printed board, which they sold these for a while in different scenario packs, and I have to say, the pre-printed boards really spoil me, because you don't have to set up all the terrain on the board.
Yeah.
It's a lot faster of a setup time, and tear down. Because putting the troops up is the easiest thing to do in this game. It's the terrain that takes forever. And actually, the troops are easy on these boards because they're printed right on the board. There's no real special units in this game. There is mostly just infantry, tanks, artillery.
Are you on this side or the other side?
I don't really care.
Okay.
I have a special mobile artillery here. These can move one and still shoot. And most of Sam's forces are special infantry units. They're called they're special forces. They're what are they called in this scenario?
Force de on the move.
No, they're motorized infantry. That's what they are. And I think that's it.
We got wheels, bro.
Huh?
We got wheels, bro.
Alright.
We don't have our little stanchions.
Who wants to know where you found that t-shirt?
This t-shirt is from Chris Cormier. He has a store on Zazzle called Geeky Goodies. And, always a possibility.
I don't think you could flip this one by yourself. Well, in a fit of rage.
You won't like me when I'm drinking, so... Alright, I think these are good match.
Will there be a QA after Sam's won? Here's the deal. The cool thing about Memoir 44 is the sides don't have to be balanced, per se. This scenario might be weighted towards the French, it might be weighted towards the German.
Five.
Yes. But the fact of the matter is that you can always switch sides and then just count the medals and combine them, which is something I'd like about Memoir. We're not going to do that today. We're just going to play this one scenario, and then depending on time, we'll answer some questions. So I'm going to go first here. So this is a tough one. I think I'm going to do a cheese card to start off with.
Wow. The Cheesemeister.
No, we're going to play Barrage. So, and we're going to hit these guys right here. Well, if you think about it, that's what we would do in a battle, is soften up with artillery. I get to roll four dice and ignore terrain. So I have to match their symbol or grenade. So I have a 50% chance.
So you're firing all those on those one on that one guy.
Yeah, I'm a jerk. Three hits.
We are still here, you silly German fools!
Alright, so then that's my turn. So I played Barrage. I don't move any of my troops. That's like a one-time shot on the board thing. It's a pretty cool card. And this guy, these three guys are going to be a pain in my neck. Because they're going to be blowing my guys to pieces.
Alright, my turn, yo.
Alright, let's see what do I have.
I didn't roll the. You can buy. This is a printed map. You can buy a breakthrough board. It comes in the expansion with, I think, like 15 breakthrough scenarios.
All right, I'm going to attack three in the middle.
All right. So Sam's playing an attack three up the middle. So that means he can move and attack with three units in the middle. Tanks can move up to three spaces and attack. Infantry can move one or two and attack. You don't have to move to attack. If infantry attacks, they roll three dice to something next to them, then two, then one. Tanks roll three dice.
All right.
Regardless of where they are.
This guy's going to take a pot shot at your tanks in the middle there.
Retreat, you silly German fools!
All right, so we have to retreat back one space, so we do so.
All right. These guys will take a shot at that infantry that was right next to it.
Since we were in a town, though, can we ignore a flag?
That's possible. Ooh, you know what? Battling in. Do we have that? I got...
Now you're minus one into a city anyway.
Okay. That's right.
So would you have shot these tanks then?
Yes.
Okay, we'll just do that.
Yeah.
So you wouldn't have rolled the dice against them to begin with.
My excitement got the best of me. All right, so anyway, we're going to take these guys against your infantry that's right beside that town then.
Retreat! Now these guys have to retreat.
You cannot retreat!
Since they can't retreat, one of them dies. So the first German casualty.
And then, this infantry unit here will shoot at that German tank squadron over there on the line, since they are not in the city.
Did you kill a tank?
Yes.
Which one?
Over here.
This one?
Yes.
All right. First German tank casualty. I have 12, 15, 18, 21. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have 24 tanks. Well, 23 now. All right, so draw a card. And... wow, this is such a pain. Such a pain. We're going to attack with three up the... oh, that's not this. That's the right card. We're going to attack with three.
Somebody text me what
middle.
He just showed you.
All right. So these infantry are going to move one. These infantry are going to move one.
Closer in the jaws of death.
And these tanks are going to move three. All right. These infantry are going to fire at yours. They're minus one, but they're... what do the barricades do?
Lets me ignore one flag.
Okay, right. So that's what ignores the flag. And then... so I only get one die against them. Normally it would be three dice, two dice, minus one. So I have one die against those guys. Of course, that was a nothing.
That's a miss!
Now the tanks are going to fire at the same guys, but unfortunately, the tanks are minus two dice. So again,
so
one die. Retreat, which you can ignore. And then these guys are going to attack with one die. This is really annoying.
Another miss!
So the Germans are proud of their initial onslaught there.
Alrighty. That was a good turn for the French. Very wells.
Someone said this game would be going differently if it wasn't for the dice towers. I have no idea what that means. Aren't dice towers like exactly the same thing as rolling dice? I mean, it's cooler. This is one of the dice towers in our Kickstarter, by the way. I like this one. It's the clear looking one. This one here was just one that someone made for me a long time ago, and I really like it. I love the whole look of it.
Okay.
I have two sets of Memoir 44, and one of the best things about that is we never have to pass dice around. We always have our own dice. We never have to worry about. All right.
Okay, here we go. We're going to...
Man, it's going to take me forever just to get rid of these three guys in the middle.
We're going to do infantry assault in the middle. We're not going to move. We're going to stay in our sandbags and our houses. But we are going to open fire, which I believe... Does it say it gives us an extra die?
You can move up to two and,
still
and battle, or move three and not battle. So you don't have to move. No, just all infantry units in
okay,
one session.
That's fine. Some of the cards that are like that do give... ordered units will give an extra die. That's why I asked. All right, so the first guy, this guy here is going to shoot the guy right in front of him. Actually, you know what?
Seemed like a good idea.
Notice it takes longer in that character.
I'm going to go here, because I'm better at the game than you are.
I'm not making any claims to be good at this.
I'm going to go the first group first on the tanks. We'll see how that goes, and that'll determine
what. So two dice against the tanks.
Yeah. That's a miss and a miss.
Yeah!
Then, yeah, we're going to have to... We'll go with these guys in against the infantry over there, right in front of them. It's a retreat.
Seriously.
And these guys here on the infantry right in front of them, also two dice. One hit.
All right. I actually would rather have the hit there than the retreat. Because I need those infantry to get up in your face. Because we're going to do an infantry assault in the middle.
There we have it.
So these guys are going to move one. These guys are going to move two, which means they can't fire.
No, they can with that.
I don't have.
No, infantry
assault. Oh, that's right. Infantry assault, they can.
You can move two and
five. Oh, well, then these guys are moving two also.
Yeah, there's no reason for it.
All right, so...
But you still have the minus...
These are two dice now.
Yeah.
Come on, kill that one guy.
Or not!
These guys are going to shoot at him with one die. Come on.
We blow our nose with your flag. Blah.
These guys are shooting at... No, wait, that's...
Are you stabbed? No,
no, I can't
on.
Do that. No, I can't do it. No, oh, I would try because...
Yeah. Getting this is two dice.
Two dice to the one next to him. Yeah! Where was that earlier? When it mattered?
Oh, here's your...
That's right, we're keeping track. Over here is death zone, okay? So he's only killed two infantry and one tank, and I've killed five infantry. Which would you rather have done?
One tank and two infantry.
Shut up.
All right, my turn. Since you were so polite...
Why do we buy two copies of the game? It's to get... because you can put two boards together to make an Overlord scenario.
It's before Overlord came out. That's why we did it.
Well, no, even when Overlord came out, it doesn't give you the extra minis, though. And the extra minis is really... Maybe Sam feels differently, but it bothers me to have tokens instead of plastic figures.
Yeah, no, that bothers me, too. Yeah, no problem.
Like, for example, even in this scenario, one set would not have given us enough German tanks. Two in the middle from Sam. A probe. And I like how this is called a probe. I think that would be more than a probe.
All right. This guy here on that guy, four dice.
Wait. Four? Who? Where?
Oh, I'm sorry. You're right. Three. Oh. You're right. Hit, and retreat.
I'll be back.
To die.
This is not a good start for me.
All right. Two in the middle. Hit and retreat.
Which one? Here?
Right there. Hit and retreat.
Hit and the retreat. This is such a pain. All this work. This is realistic, though, like to get people out of the city.
Come out of our homes, you shall not.
Okay. I've been wanting to save this card, but I'm going to have to do this. Four units of your choice. It's a really powerful card.
But dun, dun, dun.
Yeah. Two, three. Oh, why haven't
Normally, the artillery cannot move and shoot, but these are motorized artillery. They can move one and still shoot.
All right. So first, the one guy is attacking. With two dice.
I thought in your general direction.
The four guys are attacking. Yes!
I still ignore your flag as I die.
Okay, so we have one victory point now. Huzzah.
Sandbags go away.
That's right. Now these two guys are going to shoot at those two. One hit. And then the artillery are going to shoot at them. So three dice, two dice, two dice. cannot believe this. Well, at least we killed one unit. Yeah.
Yes.
Actually, that's not so bad. That lets us advance up the middle now. Memoir 14 would be two great trenches of infantry. That'd be pretty boring, I think.
That is true.
Alright, so...
Alright, here we go. I'm going to do a probe in the middle, too.
How do you keep drawing these?
Dude, just keep drawing, okay? The second... Quimassier, I don't know if I pronounced that correct. I probably didn't. It's going to move up 1, 2, 3. Fire. And then our second will go here. Let's do these guys first, because that's 3 dice on the one dude. That's a hit.
We'll gladly die to 3 tanks. Come on now. Come on.
And I'm going to do an armored advance here and shoot there.
Forgot about that.
And that's a hit and a retreat.
We're going to retreat right here.
And I can retreat here. I mean, I can do... No, I don't think I can do another armored advance.
No, you can only do one.
Yeah.
It's not a chain reaction.
I could still take ground, though, couldn't I? But I would have to move into the hex where you were. I couldn't move into the town. I'm pretty sure that's true.
No, yeah, you can't take ground, like, in a different direction.
Okay. The guy in the middle, with the 2 off on the side. Hit.
They're not roaches.
They are now.
All right. Oh, I need to draw a card. Hey, that's my card.
Too late to take it.
Oh, wait, maybe it was bad.
I didn't look at it, so it doesn't matter.
I'm playing it now! Move all units in the left flank.
Wow.
So, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. All right, so these guys can't shoot because they moved. These guys can't shoot because they have no line of sight. We're going to start with the artillery is going to hit your tanks for 3.
Okay.
We got 1 of them. And the tanks are going to hit your tanks for 3. We got another one and you retreat. Oh, lucky.
And 2. Down.
Then my 3rd tanks are going to roll 1 die on that tank in the city, missing him. Oh, the infantry hasn't fired yet. They get 1 die on the city, too. If Drew didn't go. Yeah, they didn't. Did they? No. I was hoping for a more substantial armor murder. But at least I'm moving up.
Thank you for bringing them up for me, though.
How am I supposed to get out over there? Come on, now. That's like halfway across the board. Am I just
you
supposed
can come
to...
this... Oh, wait, there's tank traps there. Sorry.
I'll go around them. We're doing like a dirt rally thing. We're going to do a Tokyo tank slide. That sounds like the name of a game. I'm going to call a game that. Tokyo tank slide. No, Tokyo tank drift. Right. All right, so... I'm going to try to focus up on the map a little bit more where we're fighting so you guys can see maybe a little bit more of what's going on here. So here, the problem with this scenario is these 3 cities here. They really are a burden on the Germans. The Germans have to break through them. Again, that's why it's called a breakthrough scenario. And I have, I think, more forces than Sam. I know I have more tanks. He only started with 3, 4, 5, 6. Actually, he started with 21 tanks, so... I don't have that many more tanks, but I have to get through all that. But I've killed 1 thing, and he's killed 2, so he is winning. I got 2 things down to 1 unit.
Recon and force.
So Samson, a recon in force, just lets him do one unit in all three sections. Yeah. Do your recon in force. I'm not worried.
Two, three. And then,
Is Memoir the best war game ever? Was this your number one on your list?
Yeah, it's my favorite war game, but that's just because it's... I definitely wouldn't say it's the best war game ever. It's my favorite war game ever. I would put it that way.
That's close enough for me.
Move those guys there. That's my one on that side.
And, all right. They're not close enough to shoot, though. Yeah,
but that's fine. Okay, so this is my one from over here. I moved him over, and we're going to take a shot here. And then I'll decide... I'm not going to move anything in the middle. And then I'll decide what I'm going to use to shoot with in the middle after that. So I've got three on those guys right there. That's one hit. Well, we won't count that one.
Hmm?
This was cocked. I hit it, and it rolled to that.
No, I'm fine with that.
Okay.
As long as we do that consistently.
Okay, two here. Thing is, it looked like it would have fell on a star.
Well, whatever.
And I hit the thing and it fell on a tank.
Just remember that next time. All right.
I will. Two hits there. Tank here to there. Battling out, though, tanks and cities. They battle
armor
out.
Armor battles out at minus two, so you only get one die.
Only one die, so. It's a retreat.
I can live with that.
We will advance and attack again.
Can't live with that! You know I was going to kill that tank, though. Alright. Alright, that's actually pretty good. Alright. Hey! We have another assault on the left. Now, if only we rolled dice properly. We'll see you later, tank. Okay, so... These guys moved two.
Can't
wait, no, not these guys. They were here, right?
Yeah, so they can't
shoot. They moved two. These guys moved two.
Can't shoot.
No, these guys moved two. These guys moved one. These guys can shoot.
Okay.
These guys can shoot, the tanks can shoot, and the artillery shooting. Artillery shooting first.
How many? You did all on the left?
Yeah, again.
Oh my goodness. All right, go ahead.
Artillery shooting the tank, that's two dice in the tank. Are you kidding me? These tanks are turning around and shooting backwards at the tank.
Oh, well, that's three dice.
Three dice. Got him. Yeah! And these guys are shooting across the river.
It took out two units, though, so we're good.
I know. Ah, we got one! All right. So we're trying to break through on the left to some degree. Unfortunately, that means I need to draw another one of those cards. We're actually using a double deck that recommends that in the breakthrough scenario. We're kind of ignoring the whole left, my right and Sam's left flank, but that might come into play later on.
Okay, two on the right. Now, just for those of you that might not know, the reason I stopped these guys here and didn't continue moving them, well, I couldn't have, but I wanted to move them here because they can be used for either.
Right, that's the exact same reason.
This flank or the center.
That's the same reason my artillery is sitting there.
So, even though I did two on the middle, I can still use these guys. I mean, two on the side. So, we're going to go one, two, three. And.
Did you have a problem with my tanks?
Fire. Well, yeah. They move three, infantry only moves two.
I wasn't even trying to shoot you guys. We're going for a pleasant stroll in the Belgium countryside.
Yes, well, you know, there we go. All right, so we'll do these guys first. Shooting back at the tanks, that's three. That's three hits,
baby.
Are
you kidding?
That was luck, that was complete, total luck. But we'll take it, we'll take it.
Yeah, oh, but now your tanks can shoot.
Now my tanks can shoot. Now, does the bridge block line of sight? That's what we need to...
I don't think so. Does not block line of sights.
Okay. Just wanted to make sure. So we've got 1, 2, 3 dice on those guys. Retreat. We'll take 2 hits.
Oh, man. All right, well, we're going to go up the center now. 3 in the middle. So, let's see. 1.
May I get a soda?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3. All right, the first thing that's happening is my artillery are going to shoot at your soldier. So that's 3, 3, 2, 2. 2 dice on your soldier. Got him. About time.
That leaves
these guys with no one to shoot at. And the tanks aren't close enough to shoot at anyone either, so that is that. Finally! Cleared those 2 towns. That took way too long, and I fear that I'm going to lose because of that. But you never know. I might get really lucky in my die rolling.
Like somebody else has.
Switch dice towers. That's a good idea. Now, I don't want this to, like, cause you to not want this dice tower. It may be me.
Okay.
All right, for all those leaving our live stream to go see the president, farewell.
See you, Bubba's. Enjoy!
Hey, if the president played Memoir, I'd go watch it.
I'm going to refrain from saying what I was going to say.
All right, well, thank you.
Anyway, I'm doing 1 on this side.
1?
Yeah.
Now, you might think that these cards are worthless and are not nearly as good, but whenever you do these, you get to draw 2 cards from your deck and keep the one of your choice. So it's kind of a... Yeah, bring them up. My infantry will hoard them. You don't know these guys are secret Nazi zombies.
We're in a tank, quite safe from zombies.
I don't know, isn't like the first episode of Walking Dead, didn't they get trapped in a tank? Or the second episode?
Okay, these are these working are tanks.
That's right. Pause in fear.
No, I'm going to move 2 up there. 3 on your 2 there. That's retreat. Wait, I'm going to see if... I'm not going to overrun. I'm just going to stay there.
You don't have to overrun, right?
No, you do not have to. It's a choice.
Alright, I'm probing. 2 on the left. Tanks are moving up. Infantry's moving up. So, first the tanks are going to fire.
Yeah! There you go.
Revenge! And that's the way dice work. They usually even out over the course of a game.
Your infantry.
And infantry. 3, 2, 1.
No, 3, 2.
Oh, that's right. It's not a city.
Right. But I ignore the flag.
All right, cool. All right, score is 4-4. First of 12 wins, so we're technically 1/3 done with the game. The Germans are slowly advancing on the left and the center. The right has not even moved. Which may have something to do with cards, but we'll see.
Yeah, losing that tank squadron really hurt.
Well, it was your main...
Yeah, it was my only guys over here.
Yeah, but the good thing about this is if I decide to book it here, I have to go past these guys first.
Wait a minute. No, okay.
Then I have to drive around like this to get over there.
Yeah.
Alright, so we started with 24 tanks.
Dang it. I only drew 1 card. This is the card that I drew.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm probably still going to take this card, but I want to see just in case.
Both good?
Yeah.
Anyhow, I started with 24 tanks. I've lost 7. So 17 tanks left. Sam started with 21 tanks and has lost 6. So 15 tanks left. So I still have a tank advantage. If you can't tell, tanks are my favorite units in this game. I love... If a scenario... I'll be honest. If I pull out a memoir scenario and there's not a lot of tanks in it, I look for one with tanks. Infantry versus infantry is fine, artillery and all that, but I just love the tanks.
Yeah, I'm actually going to take the second
one. Here, discard pile's over here. It says it's discarded.
Oh. Okay.
I want to know what you gave up. Holy moly! All right.
All right, we're going to do behind enemy lines. Behind enemy lines lets me take an infantry unit, move it 3 spaces, attack with 1 additional die, and then move it 3 spaces again. So, we're going to take a Spec Ops crew from this town, move out here.
Going for the tanks, huh?
Yeah.
You will not defeat us. But that gives you 4 dice against the tanks.
And there's only 2 of them there, so...
And you have a 50% chance, not 50, a 1/3 chance on each die.
That's a hit and a retreat, which is a death because they have nothing to retreat to.
Oh, nice. All right.
Well done. Well done, fellas. Well done.
You don't. We didn't say well done. We would like to have a word with them.
And then I just moved it back into the town. Another dead tank for you there, buddy.
We're gonna play the same card. We have a counterattack. Yeah, we'll be glad you didn't play that. Alright, we're gonna come over here. We're trying to clear these dudes out.
Yeah.
Actually, we're gonna go here. So that gives me 3 dice, right? No, you're not in the town. I keep forgetting that. That gives me 4 dice.
4 dice.
Come on. Come on.
Move it.
Doesn't matter.
It's all hits anyway.
Yes! Alright, the tide has turned!
Yes, it has.
Actually, we're still not winning, though. It's still 5-5.
Right, but you have...
But I finally got through on that side.
Completely broken flank.
We have broke through in the breakthrough scenario.
Okay.
What's the average game length in Memoir? 45 minutes, I'd say. Not including, it depends how long it takes you to set up.
Now, do you have to come here and then exit? Or is it just reaching this hex?
I think you have to land there, then exit. It doesn't actually say here. I could look it up somewhere else, but
right.
I put the guy there and get him off. Blah, blah, blah. Yeah.
Two in the middle.
Another probe. All right.
1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3.
I don't know what you got against my tanks over there. They're not even... They're sitting in the village... one of the village inns, and they're...
They're sitting on the dock of the bay.
This ain't New Orleans.
Okay, so I've got 3 tanks from both. They're not adjacent, so they're not going to be able to close assault. Armor assault anyway. So we'll just do the ones in front first. So 3 dice. That's a retreat.
And that's why you should do the ones in the back first.
Still 3 dice.
What if you had rolled 2 retreats?
That would have been a bet. And another retreat.
All right. That I don't really care for. Alright, we're going to try something new here. We're going to try 3 on the right. It's about time our right does something. Alright, these guys are going to move. 2. Man, I feel so naked out here. These guys are going to move here. And... 3, 3, 2, 2, 1. These guys are not mobile artillery, but we're going to move them up anyway, like that. They're not going to shoot, though.
Okay.
All right, so the 3 tanks are shooting at the 3 tanks. You're just sitting on the bridge, right?
Yeah, no movement restrictions, no combat restrictions, do not block line of sight. Okay,
so there we go. That's a big fat miss. The troops are also going to shoot two dice. Got one of them. All right.
Dead bottle.
That wasn't horrible. I'd like to get another one of those barrage cards.
Okay, we're going to go direct from HQ. Issue an order to 4 units of my choice.
What a cheesy card. You never would catch me using such a thing.
What did you start the game with?
I don't remember. A barrage, actually. Then that card.
Or is it 333-221? No, it's 2. Okay. 333-221. Okay. Well, the 4 units are going to be this infantry unit, this artillery, this tank, and this infantry. We're not moving anybody. These guys will shoot first at the tanks. So they have 2 dice, which is a miss. The artillery will take a shot, which is 1 dice. That's a hit.
Oh, I'm within range of your artillery.
Yes, you are. And then the tanks will shoot. With O-matic.
You were shooting at tanks, I can see.
And then the other infantry will also shoot at your tanks with 2 dice.
I'm cool with that.
Oh, that one came out. Miss, miss.
If you had shot at my men, they'd all be dead by now.
That's true.
Alright. I'm moving 3 in the middle. These guys are moving in town. These tanks. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Alright. Infantry are firing at your tanks. With these tanks here, with 2 dice. Got one. Tanks here are shooting at those tanks with 3 dice.
Missed.
Other tanks are shooting at those same 2 tanks with 3 dice.
Missed. This is ironic. The German tanks honk in this battle. It's usually the exact opposite. That's funny.
Actually, I've noticed that my dice are tending to mirror yours.
That's funny right there. I don't care what you are. I don't care who you are. Okay, we're going to do 3 on the left.
Really?
Yes. So we will start with the artillery. One die on your tanks, which is a retreat. Sir?
Mm-hmm.
Retreat.
Where?
Your tank's over there.
There's someone online claiming that this has no strategy.
Oh. It's probably the guy I was talking to about Rattlebone. But, because he swore up and down that there's zounds of strategy in Rattlebones, and there's no strategy in Memoir. Well, no, actually, he said that.
What?
There was a
same amount, right?
There was the same amount, yeah.
No.
You make the same kind of decisions. You're still rolling dice, you know, that type of thing. So whatever. All right, that was my artillery. So,
I don't really care if someone says this has zero strategy. I'm having a lot of fun.
The men will shoot at the infantry. And the guys in the town will shoot at the infantry. 2 dice. That's a retreat. Oh, that would have been a hit on the tanks. Stupid. And the tanks will take a shot at your tanks. 1 hit and a retreat.
All right. All right, the Germans are now down to 13 tanks out of our initial 24. That's sad. All right. Once again, we're playing 3 in the middle. And these guys.
Okay.
Infantry are going to fire first at the tanks. That's 2 dice in the tank. They must retreat, which kills one, right?
Yes.
And the tanks that are closer to the one tank are going to fire at it. Got them.
Okay.
And the other 3 tanks are going to shoot at your remainder tanks.
Well, stop. That doesn't count. Unless you wanted to.
Okay.
You technically could move here and attack them with this guy before you attack here. That's armor assault.
Okay, that's kind of odd.
That's armor assault.
No, I understand it's weird that we're assaulting backwards. But no, that makes sense. Okay. So this is the armor assault type. One and a retreat. And then the other three will hit you. One. All right, now I'm feeling better. I might actually pull some. No, I gotta be careful. I didn't say anything. I said I'm losing. Actually, Sam, you retreated.
Yeah, you did.
So I'm gonna go again then, right?
Yes, you can.
I will.
Because you didn't assault with those guys.
Got it.
Yes.
Okay. Now I'm feeling real good.
Yes.
Thank you to the person online who reminded me of that.
I reminded you of that.
Yeah, you did. For those just tuning in, we are playing the Breakthrough the Gembro scenario. This is, as far as I can tell, early into the German invasion into Belgium and the French resistance stopping the Germans. So far, I have killed 7 units of the French, and Sam has killed 5 units of the Germans. Although he has almost come close to killing another one. I've also basically destroyed his front line on the left, which is good, but now I just gotta zoom around. I might have this, it depends. Sam loves playing the French.
Tip! Yes. Of course I do. Let's see here.
Does your historical background say anything different than mine?
I don't think so. I don't know why it would.
Well, I don't know. Maybe sometimes it's like, the bad, evil Germans, and over here it says, the evil French.
Okay.
All right, so.
This seems...
unwinnable.
Man.
Say it.
No,
say
it's
it.
Not unwinnable. It's just... do I go for medals or do I try to block your retreat? I mean, your exit. That's the conundrum with which I am in, or within
which I am.
They said
your French people are changing into Scottish, apparently. And Sam's opinion, if the Scottish were here, the German wouldn't move at all.
The Germans would turn around and run.
Like to have you all just stutter off.
Have you played all the Memoir 44 scenarios, Sam?
Negative. That would... man, I do have a life apart from... That would... There are... including the campaign books and all... man, there's so many scenarios. All the scenarios came in the air pack. All the scenarios that came with all of the different theater packs.
And you end up playing some of the scenarios multiple times because they're so fun.
Yeah. So, I have not. Short answer.
If you're just tuning in, we're waiting for the French to decide what to do!
Yes. I'm going to counterattack, which means I'm going to do 3 in the middle.
Alright.
Off of your card.
For the person who just asked, is this more complex than Ogre? Or it's about the same. Maybe actually Ogre might be a little less complex than this. Ogre looks super complex. I was really surprised at how simple that game was compared to how it looked.
1, 2, 3.
We didn't start the fire. Yeah, we did. We started the fire.
One, two.
You trying to stop me over here?
I'm just trying to shore up my defenses.
I ain't afraid of no French.
There is nothing over here.
You got almost nothing left. You're down to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 units, 10 units. And I have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 units. Are you done? Because...
got one more.
This is making for boring viewing.
Yeah, I'm sorry, fellas.
This is the card I'm playing. You can look at this card while we're waiting.
Okay, you said... mechanized infantry can still move.
They can move two and still shoot. Okay. No, really?
Yeah.
That's kind of a risky thing.
Yeah, it is. That's why I thought so long about it. And if I whiff, they're out in the middle of nowhere. Oh, got a hit. That wasn't worth it.
One tank done.
Was not.
What was your goal? Two tanks?
Yeah, at least. I mean, I was hoping for three tanks, but...
we're playing a move out, move four infantry units. So, 1, 2. 1, 2. One, two. One, two. That's four. These guys are going to shoot at your guys with one die. Got one. And then those guys are going to shoot at your two tanks with three dice. Retreat.
You can take ground if you want.
We feel pretty happy.
Okay. Just wanted to leave that option out.
Well, you know, it looked like sitting on a bridge was a good idea next to the town. But after long and hard thought, we decided to no. All right, so this is good because I've played Sam in Memoir many times, and I'm struggling to remember any time I've ever beaten him, so this would feel good to win. I beat him in Overlord, but that's different. That's relying on the canny of my generals in the game. I'm going to get one of those stop clock things out that says it shows who takes more time on your turns.
Remember that starter off statement? Just to replay it. See, I'm pretty sure... yeah, I got to do this. All right. Recon, one on the right.
Another recon. Oh, is this tanks coming to kill my dudes?
Oh, we're gonna try it.
Oh, I know what you're trying to do here. And what? It's wicked. Alright. Actually, you can't kill them all. We can make them retreat, though, and then kill them in the second.
That's three hits.
Yeah, we survived!
Retreat, you can't get one.
We're gonna move two units
okay,
in the middle.
That was a recon, so I'm drawing two and picking one.
These tanks are going 1, 2, 3. These tanks are going 1, 2, 3. But before they leave,
parting shot.
We're giving a gift. Three dice to these gentlemen. One hit. What I really like about these dice towers is you roll the dice and then you can just pick it up and they're off. I like that a lot.
You're discarding one. Is that all you're doing?
Sam, people still have faith in you, they said.
Oh, well. That may be misplaced. I'm just trying to keep it real.
I think this scenario is slightly tilted towards the Germans.
2-2-2
Woo! You only have two on the left.
Yeah, I know.
Or you're right, I guess.
As to what to do with them, though.
We're coming for you, Margaret.
1-2-3
Well, we're mostly playing with base game rules. The only difference here is that we're playing with a bigger map. If you played the base game, there's really nothing here. I mean, we got some special units and stuff, but that's in the base game too. We're using some extra pieces, I think. Like I said, I don't think this many tanks were included in the game. I mean, I think I have 3 sets worth of tanks. I have all these tanks too. It's for when we play the Overlord stuff, that you want all those tanks.
Okay, these were still... They only moved one, though, so it doesn't matter.
That's like a suicide squad for you.
Yeah, well, you know. Maybe Captain America's with them.
As long as I can kill Bucky. Just so he can show up in another movie. Oh, spoiler!
Okay, yeah, but the thing is, you don't have anywhere to retreat, so I have a pretty good shot here.
Oh, right. That's true.
You bottled yourself up there.
Well, I'm going to kill you anyway.
All right, we're going to go with...
Oh, so you're shooting at the 3 tanks?
Infantry,
over the 2?
Infantry first.
On the tanks?
On the tanks. 2 hits.
Oh. Now you're debating?
Yeah, do I shoot at the other ones?
Well, no, what does it matter? Because if you...
These guys shoot here. My best. Got him.
Sam has now killed 6 units. I have killed 7. That's about to be 8! Just saying. Wait, what about over here?
I moved these guys over.
Oh, wow. You didn't kill my single dude there?
No.
Well,
I'm telling you, dude.
That.
I'm telling you. I've got to get rid of these things.
Well, too bad. 3 on the left. We are not going to give this one up. 1, 2. Guess we'll stop there. These guys will move 1. And these guys will move 2, which means they can't shoot. But these guys can. So 3 on your 2 men. Got him. Okay. Suicide Squad is dead. We've captured Captain America. 3 on the tanks.
No, he gave his life. In taking out those panzers earlier.
2 retreats and the tanks.
Yes.
You're welcome.
Yes.
We are...
Take it.
Yeah, we're taking the ground.
Okay. You're not adjacent, so you can't attack again.
No, I know we can't attack again, but I mean, you were going to shoot me anyway, so I might as well keep moving forward.
Yeah.
All right, I'm still feeling okay there. Losing those guys was hurt,
right.
But it wasn't the end of the world.
Okay. Issue an order to 4 armor units, armor assault. I don't have 4, I've only got 3, but I'll still take it.
Wow, that's the card I want, man!
That's the one I want!
Okay, so this lets them use 4, and they get an extra die in hand-to-hand combat, so this is a pretty obvious maneuver for them.
Okay, so we're going to go 1, 2, 3. Actually, 3. Because then you won't have line of sight if you do break through my line. But I'll still get a shot at you before you can exit. These guys, that's a no-brainer. And then that's a no-brainer. So let's do the 3-on-1 over there. Actually, they said extra die?
Yeah, so take your 4 dice.
Okay, 4 dice on the one dude. Got him.
Alright, you didn't have to like blow him apart after he was laying on the ground.
And we're not going to take ground because it won't do any good anyway.
I would.
Here, you got 4 dice on your 2 tanks. two hits.
What's happening?
And we won't take ground there either.
Any other tanks can't shoot.
And the other tanks aren't going to shoot there.
All right, Sam has now killed...
It's 8-7.
No, I got one last thing. 8-8. The problem is, even though we're tied and I'm in a pretty good position, I have to get a guy out on that side.
That's if the only way you can win?
You can still win 12 medals. No, 12 medals, of which one must be the medal collected by the first German unit. That's why I'm pushing for that, because if I don't do that...
Yeah, I got you.
Now, granted, if I kill all your stuff,
yeah,
it's the same thing.
Nuh-uh. Not according to the rules.
All right, one unit in each section. All right, hedgehogs give me cover, right?
They act like sandbags.
Moving in, they can ignore one flag. Yeah, all right, we're moving in.
And I think you battle out at -1, I think.
No. I don't think so. There's no combat restrictions.
Okay, good.
All right, so that's the one on the side. The one in the middle is going to be these artillery. Okay. And then the one over here. It's going to be these tanks. Okay. Alright, so the tanks are going to shoot first at your tanks. Okay. Retreat. The artillery, 3-3-2-2-1, it's going to shoot one at your dudes in the city. Got him. And then these guys are going to shoot two dice at your tanks. Got one of them. Yes. Wasn't a stellar turn, but it was a solid turn. If we keep pushing the French back, we might pull this off. I'm surprised it never came out like a French color. What color would be the French? I should ask you this.
Pink! No, I don't know. I would imagine blue.
Yeah, blue would be a good color.
I see yellow wouldn't look good, so I'm pretty sure they would have made blue.
Do you think now that Asmodee owns...
You did 1-1-1, right?
Yeah, you think now that Asmodee owns yellow that they won't... I mean, owns Days of Wonder, they won't push Memoir much anymore?
Who knows?
It doesn't matter. There's so much Memoir stuff out there, folks. Like Sam said, he hasn't played every scenario.
You don't
really need anything else at this point. Because you can play the each scenario. We can play this one again and again and again.
Counterattack.
Doing the same thing I did?
1-1-1, yeah.
All right.
We're going to, over here, this is going to be our move back. And then, we'll still get a shot on you there. That's my one there. And my one here will be move these tanks into the town. So they'll stay there. Alright, so I did one here, and tanks up there. So here I got three dice on your dudes.
We aren't afraid. We're not afraid.
It's a hit and a retreat.
Yeah. I can ignore one.
Yes. Okay. And then over here, I got three dice on your one tank over there. That's a hit. Oh!
Okay, now here's where I run into problems. Sam only needs to kill three more units to win the game.
Yeah.
I need to kill four, but... Okay. Well, I've been saving this one.
I thought you probably were.
Two in each section. Over here, we're going to suicide because we're going to... Oh, man, though. Is that... I don't know. Okay, well, one of the two in this section is going to be these guys. And you know what? We're going to move back, too. I don't want you to kill them right now. We're going to try to kill some units first. And we're going to move these one over here for one.
They could still fight.
Right, and these artillery are also going to go. And then over here...
So that was one, two, and one, two, and then over here.
And then one, two.
Okay. Ambush your...
All right, there's an ambush game. When I do a close assault, which is what the troops are going to do, Sam gets
you
to go first.
You only moved them one, correct? Or did you move them two?
The infantry only moved one, I think. I'm looking here. Over here. No, they did move two.
Okay, well then, I can't use the card. And they, because they can't shoot. But, no, you know I have the card.
Sorry.
That's okay. Just know it's in your future.
Yeah, those tanks are going to shoot your guys. Well.
These guys or these guys?
The tanks.
Okay, well, next time see tanks, not guys.
Well, I wouldn't have rolled three dice.
That's true.
Artillery is going to shoot at... Now we're shooting at the guy in the middle. So that's these two guys? Dice on those guys.
Okay.
Got one of them. The other artillery is shooting 3-3-2-2. One die on those guys. Got another one. Oh, those guys' days are numbered. Okay, so at this point, we both killed 9 units. It takes 12 units to win, except I have to get a guy out on the side, and Sam has really buffed up the tanks over there. I'm really not sure how I'm going to do this. All right, so let's see.
Put a 2 on this flank.
Interesting. Oh, is that the artillery?
I've cooled this down a little bit, so.
Yeah, I'm going to be, the game's going to slow down slightly here, folks. I apologize. I can't just run right up. If I get 3 units killed, I lose the game.
All right, here we go. We're going to go with, first of all, we're going to do 2 dice against, let's do 1 dice against your tanks from the artillery. Missed.
Good.
2 dice from the infantry. 2. The tanks. One retreat.
All right. All right, we're going to do 1 unit in the center, recon. And that's going to be these artillery moving here, which gives me 2 dice against your infantry in that town. Got one.
That's it?
Yeah, but it's recon. So I can draw 2 cards. That's I actually played it because I wanted the ability more than the thing. I'm getting rid of a 1-1-1 recon.
Okay, we're going to do artillery bombard.
No.
I can move 3 hexes or battle twice, so I'll battle twice.
All right, what's that, 2 dice twice against my infantry?
Yep.
All right.
First 2, it's a hit.
Okay, good.
Second 2, 2 hits.
Well, that's problematic. We're playing their finest hour!
I drew air power.
You draw a replacement. Well, we're supposed to shuffle now anyway.
Okay.
Because I drew their finest hour.
So you want me to put this back in shuffle?
No, because I would have played this now.
Okay.
All right, this lets me roll 6 dice.
Oh, blah.
And for each unit, I roll. Why
did you get that?
That's why I played the
are
recon.
Supposed to shuffle this?
Yeah, wait, here's the other ones. When we're done. So stars. So grenades are the bad thing. I don't want to roll any grenades.
Grenade heavy? Yes!
That one was a grenade. Okay, or flag, it doesn't matter. Okay, so...
Star is a wild. You can order 1 tank, 1 infantry, and then one whatever you want.
All right. Well, the infantry is going to...
And the card is in here, right?
Move here. The tanks are going to move here. And then the whatever I want is going to be the artillery. Everyone gets an extra battle dice, so...
Hey, stop, though. I do have that card.
Right, but I'm shooting with the artillery first.
Okay.
The artillery is 3, 3, 2, 2, 1, but they're two dice because of the...
Yeah. One hit.
And then I'm attacking with the guy, and this is where you're doing the ambush? Or no?
Yes.
All right. Man, I can't believe I rolled 3 grenades.
Yeah, I know. That sucks. It really does.
Ah, okay, so
here's the ambush card. And I didn't read it, though. Does it give any plus dice? I don't think it does. It just lets me attack first.
Nah, yeah, you just get the attack. You know, I'm good. So
3 against the 1. Got him.
All right. That's 10 units. 2 more. Now my tanks go, which are a whole lot less useful. 2 dice against Sam.
That's
I got him.
Hit, yeah.
Yes! Alright, I got 10 of Sam's, he got 10 of mine! Oh, the pressure!
Okay. So, let's see here.
Alright, now how do I get around, though, without you killing 2 units? So that's the problem. Sam has... Okay, so let's do kind of a look at where we are. This is Sam's backup last defense force there. You can see his 3 infantry units and 2 tank units. And then over here, he has 1 artillery.
Yep.
I have over here 2 full infantry, an artillery, and a tank. Oh, no, Sam has that single guy in that town, too.
Yeah.
That guy's going to die. I'm just telling you guys. Okay. Over here, I have an artillery and an infantry. And then I got a tank unit and 3 infantry units. It's really any person's game, but I shouldn't have said I was going to win.
He's going to die. He's gonna go out in a blaze of glory, baby!
Well, you might have stayed there longer.
No. Let's have fun, shall we? 1, 2.
Are you really going to...
Yeah.
Craziness. Look what Healy is doing!
Vive la France! Alright, here we go.
If you roll 3 tanks here, then I think we'll surrender as Germans, because that would be shameful. The tanks are going, and this is like the group from Saving Private Ryan.
One retreat. Yeah, 1 retreat.
1 retreat. We will retreat here. Would you like to take ground?
This is my bridge! Now go away before I taunt you a second time!
Alright, cool head, Vasel. You don't want to just kill that guy.
Alright, and now I got to draw 2 to come back up to 5. Because I played the ambush.
Right. I don't want to waste a card on that stupid guy. I will, though. 3 on the right.
This is your last little foray of fun. Now, after this, you have to focus on this.
Well, I know, but...
You did 3 on the right?
Yeah. Wow. Artillery is shooting first.
Okay.
That's 2 dice.
Yeah.
Got him.
Yep.
Alright, and the tanks can't see the artillery.
Yes.
And my artillery can't reach yours. So.
Alright,
so I've killed now 11 units. 12 for me to win, but I have to get one off, so at this point, killing Sam's stuff doesn't matter to me. I have to get a guy off. I mean, I'm killing his stuff just to stop it from killing me. And that was a great card to draw. That was not foreshadowing. I meant that card sucked.
Barrage.
No.
Yes.
No, that's a stupid card. Should be in the game. Should be allowed.
You already used it once.
Yeah. That's what I would have shot too.
Guys hiding in the trees. A hit and a retreat.
Oh, yes. Yes.
That was a lackluster roll.
We're moving everybody on the left. Alright, how do I do this without dying here, though?
Okay. Use him.
Yeah, he's actually going to move over out of the way. These guys are going to move too. They're moving up. They're moving up. And that's all I have in the left. No shooting. Your turn. I'm going to keep drawing until I get a barrage card.
I need barrage cards. That's all I'm looking for.
Are you feeling good?
No.
Why? All you gotta do is kill two guys.
Yeah, but anything can happen in the game, man. Fog of war, bro.
I gotta get these guys out. Those guys are ticking me off.
Oh, let's see.
Well, Ian, I'll answer your question about my favorite scenario. My favorite scenario is the tank battle. Is that Kursk? Is that the... There's a giant overlord tank battle. By far my favorite.
On that snow?
Yeah.
Yeah, that is a cool one. The snow map.
And then I also like some of the ones that deal with the tiger tanks. There's one with tiger tanks I like a lot. And then I like the one... I still like the one where you drop the guys on the board as paratroopers. It's not that cool. I'm just, that idea is a neat idea for me.
Yeah, that's the best way to do it, I think. 2-2-2
Really? Let's do it. You just want to shoot that artillery.
Oh, I have to.
Yeah, you do. Because we is coming for you. Man, I'm nervous now, though.
When Johnny goes marching home again, hurrah, hurrah.
Curse, that's right.
I'm going to move them here instead of those trees.
The Normandy landings are fun to play. I just play them so much, I think, compared to the regular ones. There's also not as many tanks in those, and I like tanks.
Yeah. And then we'll shoot these guys. That's three dice.
It is. Oh!
Yeah.
Three in the middle. I miss
really?
You're gonna blow the crap out of me though. Right?
Really? Well, yeah. But I mean, they're in trees, so you're battling in at minus one.
No, you're right.
You have to roll grenades only.
We're gonna come over this way. And these guys are gonna leave the safety of that. Mobile one. What does that matter?
Is that the mobile one?
Yeah.
Okay.
3-3-2-2-1-1 3-3-2-2-1-1 That's all I can do. Alright, your turn. Kind of hard to kill the German.
Make sure I have. Hold on. Yeah.
Wasn't that nice of Sam to stop me from dying? Such a gentleman.
Oh, you wanted this.
I don't know what that is.
You wanted it. I've guaranteed it.
Well, then you play it.
I'm going to. But, oh man, see, I can't. All of my forces are...
See, what this game does is it kind of limits you. Like, if you stick, like what Sam does, he has no one in his left flanks except for his artillery. So all the left cards he gets are kind of worthless.
Oh, I'm going to do it anyway. You definitely wanted this card. Medics and mechanics.
Oh, that is what I wanted!
You definitely
okay,
wanted
so this
that.
Lets Sam basically build up a unit. Well, why are you playing it? Just to be a jerk?
Get him up to full strength, might as well.
So he's going to roll five dice.
Five dice, correct. And as long
as he rolls at one tank or a star, he's fine.
Right. Man, I got the tank.
Yeah, because I wanted to buff up this one.
Yep.
All right. Well, I'm doing a recon over on the left flank, the right flank for me. And I'm going to move these guys into the center flank, please. I want to do that. I'm going to move these guys up like this, actually. But I get to draw two cards and keep one. Come on. Did you draw air power again? Or no?
No, I just left it out.
I'm getting rid of a probe. Two on the right.
Okay.
So, basically, I just moved these guys up here so that I could draw two cards. You know, this game plays pretty quickly. We've only been playing a little over an hour, and this is like a double-sized scenario.
Yeah. No, that's one of the things I really like about it. It is true that setup takes sometimes. Setup can take just as long as the game does.
If you're playing a huge scenario like this.
If you're playing a huge scenario.
A regular scenario, we're talking 10, 15 minutes usually. Yeah. Well, maybe not. It depends how fast you are. For us, it's harder because we own everything too, though. You got to find all the right terrain tiles.
Okay, I'm going to order...
You're playing a surrender card?
2 units in the middle.
Hmm. Alright, well that was boring. 3 on the left. 1, 2. Those are annoying. I can't disable them. I can only disable part.
No, they're impassable. Well, let's read it.
No, they're not.
French. Infantry may move in or through and battle. Yeah. Impassable by armor and artillery. No combat restrictions. Infantry and hedgehogs can ignore one flag. Do not block line of sight.
All right. These guys get one die against your tanks.
Okay.
I'm going to re-roll that because that's totally cut.
Yes!
That was a tank that you had put together with duct tape.
I'm going to fire that mechanic.
Yeah. All right. All comes down to this. This is a good scenario, actually.
Mm-hmm. Direct from HQ. This year, you ordered 40 units of my choice.
What?
That double deck makes that card come up a lot more often.
And then
reshuffling, when you made it reshuffle, just put it right back in. Because both of us has played that.
Yeah, well, there's two of them in the deck, too.
Yeah, I know.
I like the double deck myself.
Yeah.
Because it means
this one's definitely taking a shot. 3, 2, 3, 3, 2, 2, 1. So let's just get that out of the way.
Well, are you going to move anything?
Yeah, I guess I didn't do anything.
Because you got to do your movement first. Shooting.
Do that fast. And you are tempting me.
To come out?
To come out of my defensive posture.
Yes, I know. I have to. I can't. What am I supposed to do? Just come up there and sit there while you take pot shots?
What am I talking about? Of course I'm going to come out. We are the French. You cannot beat us here.
One.
And you're doing air artillery, so that's 2.
Yeah. 3.
They're only moving 1.
Yeah. Okay, fine. I'll move them 2.
No, I wasn't saying you had to.
I'll do that. Alright. These 3 over here. Thank you for encouraging me to move the extra. I didn't see that line aside.
Alright.
Alright, well let's do these guys first. 3 on 3, 2 tanks on 3, 3 dice, 1 hit. That wasn't.
What were you shooting? The tanks?
Yeah. Oh. I did this first.
Why didn't you shoot? Okay.
I understand. And 3 here.
I can ignore 1 flag.
Yes, I can. But you take 2 hits.
Oh man.
Run away.
Artillery?
Oh yeah. 1 die on the tank. Retreat.
I will. Thank you. Okay, we're doing a close assault. Issue an order to all infantry and army units adjacent to enemy units. I can add an extra die. Units may not move before they battle, but they can take ground.
You get 4 dice twice.
Yeah, we're going first.
That's on 2 tanks.
4 dice against those 2 tanks. Got them.
Yep.
So now I've killed 12 things, but that does not win me the game. But I did get rid of those tanks. All right, Sam. You're down to one last tank squadron.
So
is that new?
You've got the 12 medals. So now you have to push through to win.
Right.
Okay.
But the reason I need 12 medals is because if I just went and ran up, I might be able to pull that off. Again? Stop shooting at that tank. He's done nothing to you. That's a lie. He killed a lot of your men.
I would if I could.
Alright. Need to get rid of those tanks. I need a barrage guard. That's what I need.
All right, two units on the right. So we're definitely taking that pot shot. And for the life of me, I can't remember where these guys came from. I think they came from here, so they can only move one and shoot. So they're not going to move. And these guys...
Oh, that's right, because we didn't put markers on them.
All the guys back here were non-special units. All the special units were up there. So I know these three guys, they cannot do that. So here's the thing, and here's the decision I have to make before any dice are rolled. Okay, I could conceivably move 1, 2, 3, hit these guys,
advance and shoot at that guy,
advance and shoot at this guy, and win the game. I could conceivably do that, but do I risk it?
If they die, then I'm just going to slowly walk up there with all my infantry until I'm close enough. But you still might win. You only need to kill two units.
I know.
What would the French do?
Take it to committee. let's see. Quick consensus. Make a post.
No, they can hear you in the mic.
Okay. Well, no, I'm just saying. Okay, but you need to make a post that they can flag, that they can thumb up. Make a post that they can thumb up.
Oh, you can't see that on the live chat thing.
Oh, you can't?
Well, I mean, we'll hear some answers. Okay.
All right. For the next minute, you tell me what I should do. Should I stay in my defensive posture or go for the win right now?
So he's talking. He's would go up here. He attacks with 3 dice. If he hits on 2 of them, they're dead, he moves in here, then he gets 3 dice against that guy, and if he gets him, he wins the game. If he fails, that tank squadron is dead, probably.
Possibly, yeah.
Hopefully. Alright. Go for glory. Go all in. Defense. Okay, that's 2-1. Charge. 3 for the win. 4. Do it. 5. Go for win. Defense. 2. Go for win. Go for win. 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 Attack. Win. Okay, it's about 5 go for it into 1 defense, about. This guy said defense like the Scots, build a wall. Yeah, but most of them are saying go in for the win. Kill, kill, kill. Okay, guys. There's a human being on the other side. Just remember that. Yeah, it's really the best defense, a good offense. You said you'd listen to him.
Here we go.
All right, hang on. I need to focus on the roll.
3 tanks.
All right, he needs 2 hits here. So grenades or tank symbols. Actually, retreat would also work. It wouldn't win him the game, but it would still...
It would still weaken.
It'd be better.
All right, here we go.
All right, so 3 retreats.
3 retreats.
That's an unusual...
Back on up.
1, 2. Oh,
and
that kills a tank.
Yes.
I'm assuming you're moving in then.
Yeah. Now we need to look at the armor advance though. Can I only move 1 or can I move?
No, you move into the spot
it's
that
it's
was
a take,
just,
ground, yeah, and then, take ground and then fire. Okay. So I'm going to take ground and then I'm going to attack this little guy.
All right.
That's my best bet. There's more infantry figures there. And we
All right, Sammy needs to kill 1 more guy to win.
Thanks, fellas and ladies, if there are any out there.
That was like the middle result, kind of, sort of. Better than that. All right, 2 on the left. Now I gotta try to kill this tank squadron. One. Oh, if I move into forest, I can't battle that turn, though.
Right.
All right, we'll move him here and here. We're just gonna go for it. All right. Infantry is firing twice at the tanks.
Huh? Oh, two dice.
Got one of the tanks. Now the tank is firing at the tanks.
Oh, my goodness.
Ding dong! The tank is dead! The tank is dead! The wicked tank!
Okay, yes, he is. He is actually stomping around the room like one of the fairies in The Wizard of Oz.
They weren't fairies, they were munchkins.
Okay, they look like them.
All right, your turn.
Oh, boy. Hey. All right.
Did you happen to draw a card on the left? Because you could shoot at that tank again. All right, now the game's going to slow down, I think.
Yeah. Grenades, grenades, grenades. Dig me in.
So if Sam kills one unit, he wins. If I manage to get a guy off the board, which is problematic because I have some tank units and...
Okay, here we go. One unit on the right. Move back. That's two. They cannot fire. Didn't want to fire.
You wanted to recon.
Yep.
I'm reconning also! Except I'm actually moving up with these infantry.
Golly.
Well, that's not a big deal, but hey, you stopped me from drawing it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm throwing out an all of the left. On the right, I mean.
Okay, so you just moved those guys up?
Yeah, I did the same thing you did, a sortie.
Okay. All right, I'm moving throwing a move out, which is probably a card you could have used.
Nah, I could have used the move out.
All right, and I'm going to... It's my turn to go now?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to use Recon and Force, 1-1-1. So we're going to take a shot over here.
That is not a glorious way to end the game.
No, but the French will rule the day. The Germans will rue the day. okay, anyway. One tank or grenade.
Okay.
That doesn't count. Wait.
There was a star.
No, it doesn't count. Here we go. Ding dong, the witch is dead.
All right.
The French are victorious.
They are. So that's their 12th unit, so they won. If that hadn't happened, my only goal was to just... I was going to leave the tank here, actually.
Yeah.
And bring these guys up slowly. Yeah, and the artillery up.
Yeah.
And then just... But the thing was, you could have got a barrage at any point or something.
Yeah. All right. That one really makes it hard for the Germans.
But it's a good one because the Germans have better forces.
Yeah.
And things. Here, bring your chair over here. We'll do like maybe 10 minutes of questions, folks, because we do have to go to dinner and such.
It's going to be an upward shot.
You're in that chair.
Okay.
Mess these wires up too much. Alright, Q&A time. Just a bit of Q&A. Are we not... Oh, you don't want to look at our stomachs?
That's a better shot.
Alright.
Alright. So,
what
do you think?
So, if you guys have any questions... Oh, you just rolled the... Alright.
Alrighty then.
We, All right, no questions yet. Just I'll address the extra pledge levels, and I'll talk about it. I'm going to do an update tomorrow, or maybe even later tonight. There'll be an update that will talk about the extra stretch goals, I have the artwork for the playmat, which you guys would like, I think. Sam likes it.
Yeah, it's a very cool playmat. You will definitely enjoy it. Is it still pulled up?
No.
No, it's not.
Okay. Can you talk Tom and the Plain Combat Commander. Well, even if I could, I don't know if that would be a good one to watch.
Yeah, with Memoir, you have the different, you have the minis, you've got the aesthetic look of the, I mean, the maps on Combat Commander don't look bad. But you just have a bunch of little cardboard chits that you're moving around. So there's less of an aesthetic appeal, and it doesn't play as fast as Memoir does. So that's why I think it would probably be not as good of a live play.
Does beating me ever get old?
Nah.
How many of the paper maps are there? There's like six, maybe?
Yeah. And I think there... Some of them are double-sided, I think.
Yeah, some of them are double-sided.
So
this one is double-sided, but it's blank on the other side. It's if you want to make your own
scenario.
Breakthrough scenario. I think. Yeah, okay, yeah.
Heroes of Normandy versus Memoir. I've never played Heroes of Normandy. And I don't know how that actually happened. Have you got it from them yet?
Yeah, no, you never. I
wasn't around for some reason.
There was something going on. Yeah, I like it, but Memoir is better. But the Heroes of Normandy, you have like fewer units and you move them around. And you feel it's more like a miniatures game.
Yeah, it's a little bit more of a, on a more of a minute scale, a squad level
combat. What's for dinner?
I have no idea.
You wear the same stuff for purpose? I don't know what that means.
Huh?
We're not wearing the same stuff. We're in two different shirts. I'm a werewolf.
Yeah, the table. I don't think I've...
All right.
I've never worn this on a video. Well, I have worn it on a video.
Do you... But that someone asked what Kickstarter... We're actually running a Kickstarter for the Dice Tower right now. If you search in Kickstarter for Dice Tower, you can find out about it.
Yeah, go check it out.
Do you enjoy Memoir with Team Play 2 vs. 2? Have you ever played 2 vs. 2?
No.
We have played 3 vs. 3 before, where one person was a player and the overlord.
Yeah.
I don't like that, though, because
I'd rather go all out and play 4v4, where there's one overlord, there's like a general, and then he has three field commanders, and then the other side is the same way. I like that version a lot best. And then when you go to overlord, it actually gets bigger than that. So 2v2, nah, not so much.
Someone mentioned an XCOM Live, XCOM... Play live, that'd be fun. We'd have to play it first with Sam to get him. And Tide of Iron, this guy loves Tide of Iron.
Yeah.
Is it worth getting Memoir, or should you move to different commands and colors? If you love Tide of Iron.
If you love Tide of Iron, should you get Memoir or a different command and colors? Is that what you said?
Yeah,
is that what you're talking about?
See, the commands and colors to me is basically what period of history do you like?
Ancient warfare, yeah.
If you like ancient warfare, get that. If you like Napoleonics, get that. Memoir's going to feel a lot simpler if you like Tide of Iron, I think. But Memoir lets you have a lot more forces. Tide of Iron's letting you control a few things. It's almost, again, like a miniature game. It's squad warfare.
It focuses in on a skirmish rather than maybe a battalion level.
And I think that's why I like Memoir better sometimes, because I don't want to play the whole war all the time, and
right.
I don't want to play like individual units. I like this. It kind of, when my guy dies, I'm not so sad,
right?
Because I don't know who he is.
Yep.
Your defense was as solid as the 85 Bears.
Yes, I. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! I love that compliment. Yes.
Let's see. Skirmish Imperial Assault would be good. Yeah, that's a good idea. I should do a Skirmish Imperial Assault. We'll see. I can't do these every day, but I'm trying to do at least one a week, but that's not always going to happen. You can't hold me to one a week, but we'll see.
It's hard.
Battlelore 2. We'll do a Battlelore at some point.
Especially the new one. The new one's really pretty.
And the expansions, we're probably going to wait for the expansion to play with some of the new, where we can build our armies a little bit more, like secretly, and so you don't know what your opponent's going to take.
Cool.
What's your favorite Civ building game?
Civ building. You know, it's going to seem really, really strange, but I really think my favorite Civ building game only would be Roll Through the Ages. I enjoy Civ building, I guess, but it's just not very fun in a board game style. I would like the video game format a lot better, but Roll Through the Ages is one that I really enjoy.
Yeah. For me, I don't know. I do like, I like Nations, but kind of long.
I guess I'll, yeah. Nations had a very anticlimactic end.
Through the Ages is good. Well, I almost want to say Twilight Imperium, because it does have a civilization feel to it. No, Seven Ages. I'm sorry. Seven Ages.
Yeah.
It's just that it's really long.
Yeah.
Really long, but that's what it is for me.
Right. Yeah, I can see that, but again, if I'm going to spend that much time on a game, it's going to be TI3.
There's High Ground Terrain coming out in Kickstarter. Is it more HeroScape compatible terrain? I don't know. If they make terrain that's compatible with HeroScape, first of all, I don't think they can. I think they've patented the HeroScape terrain. I don't know how you can make something that worked with it. If you did make something, though, that did work with it, I don't need to buy any because I have tons of terrain already.
Yeah.
But I will. Any chance to see a live play for TI3? No, but Sam did a video.
I just, on Martin Luther King Day, I went over to a friend of ours' place and we played a four-player version of TI3, a four-player game of TI3, and I did a stop-motion video of it. We just let it run during the whole time. So one of the first things I want to do, Tom just gave me one of the older cameras, and I got to get a tripod and all that kind of stuff. And that'll probably be one of the first videos I do, just kind of like a... the way I'm thinking about it right now is more of just a low level introduction, not really a how do you play the game, but a low level introduction to, because there's a whole bunch of really good videos out there on TI3 on how you play the game. So this is more going to be more of a low level introduction to the game, and then we'll stick that in there a little bit. But a live playthrough, I don't think he'd do it.
Someone here asked is it worth it to get the equipment pack? I don't think either one of us has the equipment pack.
No,
we
don't.
That's the one thing I never got.
Yeah, it's just kind of flown under the radar a little bit.
You know what I don't like about the equipment pack is that all the plastic in it is a different color.
Mm.
And I don't know what the reason... I mean, like when they did the Tiger tanks for the Germans, yeah. They were that white color. They weren't...
Yeah.
And that works okay with the Germans because the white's kind of similar to gray.
Right.
But if it's in the Allies, I don't know, why could they make those trucks green or something?
It could be British, though. British forces are...
Well, right, and that's the point of it, is that you can use it with any of the armies.
Yeah.
Okay. There's a couple more.
I would get the equipment pack. It's just flown under the radar for me right now. But yeah, it's on the docket.
Fortress America live play. Fortress America is a long game.
Yeah.
I like it, but it's like 4 hours. With two people, it might be faster, but I don't know. Maybe. Mm. Ghost Stories live play is going to happen.
That'll be fun.
And let's see here. Ooh, Battle Lore 2 or Memoir? I can't remember which one you liked better.
Battle Lore 2 or Memoir? Well, I'm a World War II history fan, so anything... now I'm not fanatical about it. I don't know all of the details and that type of stuff, but I'm a sucker for it. I guess I'll put it that way. So Memoir is just based on that alone, it's above Battle Lore 2. But especially Battle Lore, the second edition. Battle Lore 1 I was kind of done with, but Battle Lore 2, with the variable setups that you can have with it, that really changed the game a lot for me and made it much more interesting. So it's a very close second to Memoir, but I like Memoir better, I'll put it that way.
Someone asked if 90 minutes was typical for this game, because our game took 90 minutes, and yep. No.
Well, I think so.
For a breakthrough, yes.
Oh, you're talking about, it's not, that's the longest it would go. That's
right.
What I was
This thinking. Is a double scenario. The regular scenarios, they really take about 45 minutes, so this took about twice the length.
Yeah.
Yeah, so... Don't take this as an ordinary memoir scenario. This is like a cool one to watch.
It's an expansion that you can buy for this map. So it's the breakthrough pack, and it's definitely not like what you would get in the base core game. But all of the mechanics, most of the rules are the same as what you would see in the base game.
Yeah, we're not doing Rune Wars live. Sorry. Didn't like it enough to want to do that. No. Someone wants to know how many times you played Twilight a year, Twilight Imperium.
Twice? Well, yeah, that was where it really works out to, because I have such a busy schedule at the school and church, but it really is, you have to schedule an actual day. I think last year, I may have only played it once, and that was at Dice Tower Con.
Are you going to probably do that every Dice Tower Con now?
Maybe, if they're willing to do it, yeah. But I'm really becoming more specific about the number of players I want to play TI3 with, and I don't think I'll ever play with 7 or 8. 6 is my cap, and that is if everybody knows how to play the game well. I think that's what we played at Dice Tower Con. It was either 5 or 6 last year. 4 is, again, gotta know the game, otherwise it can really drag out. And it's not necessarily a bad thing. You still have the camaraderie of all the players, but the actual game is, it does take a while when you have to stop every turn and explain stuff. And again, that's not a bad thing, it's just it takes longer. So I'm a little bit more picky. I'm becoming more picky, I think, with every play.
Well, that's it about this time, folks. We'll do more Q&As and stuff in the future and do more live plays. Thanks for watching. I thought that was a pretty close game, actually.
Yeah, very close.
You had,
very close.
You had 3 infantry units and an artillery unit left. That was it.
Mm-hmm.
And your artillery unit won it for you.
Yep.
All right. Anyway, folks, I'm Tom Vasel.
And I'm Sam Healey. Thanks for watching, y'all.
Yeah, maybe one of these days you'll see me win. Well, I beat Jason. That's right.